Yesterday, we saw Halo Infinite at the Xbox and Bethesda showcase, and today we got a deeper dive into the multiplayer. So yesterday, during the E3 and Bethesda showcase, they had a quick sizzle trailer for Halo Infinite's multiplayer, and it just looked like a ton of fun. And today on the Halo YouTube channel, 343 went into a deeper dive as to what we can expect with Halo Infinite multiplayer. Now, this multiplayer, from what they showed off today, looks like just classic, fun, awesome Halo, and I could not be more excited, especially based off of a lot of the stuff that they talked about. So firstly, the most important thing when it comes to these free-to-play multiplayer games is how are they going to monetize the game? And we have some good news here. There will be absolutely no loot boxes or other randomization systems in the game. There will be a battle pass, so there's going to be seasonal updates to Halo. But the good news around that is that once you buy a single battle pass, you're going to be able to continue leveling up that battle pass forever. It won't expire when the season ends, so you're only going to have to make that one-time purchase. And this is awesome because with free-to-play multiplayer games, they have to monetize the game somehow, and they have to continue to grow the game by adding updates. And they do that generally through things like battle passes and seasonal updates, new game modes, new playlists, stuff like that. And once you purchase that first battle pass, you won't have to worry about thinking about, do I have to purchase the next one coming up? It really will incentivize people to purchase that first initial battle pass that comes out. I will probably pick it up, especially because I know I'll be able to continue to level it up. And Halo being a free-to-play game can literally last forever. They can continue to just add to the base foundations of the game, and we can see Halo Infinite being maybe the last Halo multiplayer, or just the ultimate multiplayer, where they continue to add on for years and years to come, even lasting this entire generation. Now, speaking of the actual multiplayer itself, it is going to be quintessential Halo, they say. So they say with Halo Infinite, the team at 343 Industries is embracing the franchise's legacy while imbuing it with new modern twists to lean into the series' strengths, while simultaneously laying a foundation on which to grow and further evolve in the months and years beyond launch. And like I said, they're going to continue updating it. They're going to continue adding stuff to the game. But what is very encouraging here is that they are focusing on that sandbox arena style gameplay with a variety of weapons and vehicles and the ability to find equipment throughout the game while you're playing a multiplayer. So they say here that Halo 3-esque equipment, game-changing limited use abilities that players will be able to scavenge during the match is going to be a big part of it. The threat center is an area of effort support device that periodically pulses and illuminates an enemy players within the radius, while the aptly named repulsor can be used to deflect projectiles and anything else that gets in the way. And then there's the grapple hook. So they say whether it's zipping across a map to gain high ground using a grapple shot or digging in your defenses with a drop wall, equipment brings new strategic and tactical options to Halo Infinite's frenetic multiplayer combat. So there's going to be new equipment that we're going to be able to use. And with Halo, one of the best things about equipment is what it brings just to the overall multiplayer with the organic things that occur. Like, I can see so much crazy stuff happening with the grapple shot, crazy explosions, crazy kills from that. So I'm just so excited to see how this is all going to work out. We know there's going to be obviously vehicles in Halo, and a big part of these vehicles are going to come in to big team battle. So there's going to be obviously the arena, which is the main Halo playlist, the main Halo multiplayer mode. And then you have big team battle, which is the bigger maps. You got the vehicles, you have more people within the lobbies, and it's getting even bigger with going from 16 players to 24 players. And generally in big team battle, that's where you see some of the craziest stuff happening with kills, with vehicles, and how people are taking out the other team. And I think with the new actual equipment, with the new systems in place, we may even see some crazier stuff. And it's going to make for a great fun game mode, but I think it's also going to make for so many cool highlight reels. When it comes to crossplay and split screen and 120 FPS, there's lots of good news here. So crossplay between console and PC is going to be there. You're going to get up to 120 FPS on the Xbox Series X. And then on PC, obviously there's going to be a bunch of different settings. You're going to be able to tinker with your graphics to get the most frames per second. And something that is very exciting is that Halo Infinite will also support split screen on Xbox and LAN play via a PC local server. So I know for a lot of people out there, they may be too young to have remembered how fun it was to play Halo 2 with your friends at a LAN party, it all in one room, everybody having their Xboxes. And like, that was just such a great time. And to know that we're still going to be able to get that local split screen multiplayer with Halo Infinite, I think it's going to just bring a lot of people back together with parties and just having a great time, because it is honestly one of the best multiplayer local split screen games ever made, in my opinion. Like, Halo 2 was just incredible. Halo 3 was a ton of fun, and it wasn't there for Halo 5, which was a big disappointment. But yeah, overall, Halo Infinite is sounding awesome. I cannot wait to play it. And if you want to be part of the flight test for it, you got to be in Halo Waypoint and make sure that you're registered and everything. I have that all ready to go, so hopefully I do get selected. But anyways, guys, that's it for me. Let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Let me know what you think about Halo Infinite. Do you think what they are doing with the multiplayer is going to be good and bring Halo back to its prominence in the promised land of where it was with Halo 2, Halo 3, and overall, just how excited are you for the game? If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new here and you like what you see throughout this video, I'd really appreciate you hitting that subscribe button to help this channel grow, help grow this community so we can have great conversations in the comments below. Thank you, man, for watching. Thank you for your support, and I'll catch you in the next video. We'll be right back.